Hello Android developers! My name is Mohsen and I'm back with another helpful open source library to improve your Android app's quality. Before I start, to support this channel, do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to get a notification when there is a new video. Let's start. In this video, I'm going to introduce to you the Leak Canary, another valuable open source library from Square. As every good Android developer should know, Android devices usually come with limited memory resources, and a memory leak can cause serious issues and fatal crashes for the apps. Memory leak means keeping a useless reference to an object that should be destroyed and fooling the garbage collector to not collect that useless part of the memory. Some of the most common memory leaks in Android apps are keeping a reference to activity or fragment. Such memory leaks can easily be overlooked even by experienced Android developers. Leak Canary is a memory leak detector that uses its knowledge of the Android framework internals to help developers reduce the out-of-memory error crashes. Setting up and using this library is very simple. You only need to add the dependency to your app. Leak Canary automatically detects leaks of a destroyed activity, a destroyed fragment, a destroyed fragment view, and a cleared view model. Also, you can watch any other object that's no longer needed manually. Leak Canary uses a class called AppWatcherInstaller that is a content provider. Content providers are loaded before the application class is created, and the library uses this hack to install AppWatcher on application start. The Leak Canary keeps a weak reference to the object after it has been destroyed and checks after 5 seconds to see if it's removed from the memory by GC or retained. Normally, a retained object should be garbage collected, but Leak Canary doesn't have any idea why it is not happening. And to do this, it uses Shark to create a dump from the heap. By opening the Leak Canary, you will see detailed view of the leaks. The details screen shows a trace of the memory leak that starts from the garbage collector route to the object passing the leak reference. You should follow the detailed list looking for the point that you're keeping the reference to that object. For a quick demo, I'm going to add it to a sample app and see the result. As you can see in this sample app, after switching to the second screen, the old fragment is going to destroy its view, but the reference that has been passed and retained doesn't allow it to be garbage collected. To fix the memory leak in this fragment, I will release those references by setting them null on destroy view. I also need to define a nullable backing property. Finally, thanks to the Leak Canary, the problem is solved and there is no memory leak anymore. Hopefully, you also found this tool useful and are going to use it in your apps to avoid overloading the Android device's precious memory and random crashes in your app. If you liked this video and want to see more, do not forget to subscribe to this channel, and also do not forget that sharing is caring, so share this video with other Android developers. Bye bye.